Hello everyone, this is Akash Chauhan and this is your third lecture over functions, and in today's lecture we will be discussing about inline functions and recursive functions. So without any further ado, let's start the inline function. So before having the discussion, let me take an example so that we can understand what is the need of using an inline function. Okay, what was the basic need of using this function? So let me take an example. So this is the simple code that we have been using for a very long time. So again, two variables, 10 values, and we are calling add functions, and it will return addition of these two values, and we are printing that. So if you pay little attention on this fact, that this code is quite small in the function. Okay, it is just one line. So the program counter is the one who is responsible for reading and executing the line. So let me write this PC. So PC would come here, it will call the add function. Okay, pass the value. Okay, look at the process of calling the function. Okay, it will check the declaration, it will pass the parameters, it will call, and the CPU or the PC would come here to execute it. Okay, the program counter would come to execute this line and it will return back, and then the program counter will reach to this line. So there is a switching overhead if you pay little attention to that. So to just access this logic, we are spending too much time over switching back and forth to the function. So if there is a small logic, I don't think there is a it is a good practice to use function for that. But I have already told you that what if we are going to use this logic 1000 or 10,000 times, and that was the motive behind developing a function. So the writing of this function is okay, because we don't need to write this code again and again. But what I want, this switching overhead from this line to this line and then executing just one line, okay, just this line returning A plus B and then getting back to the sum, this program counter, and program counter will start executing the next statement from here. So this whole thing switching back and forth, I don't want. So for that, there is a way to do. If you want to minimize this overhead, then what if we can substitute this code? Okay, we don't need to write this code again and again for the addition. The code would always be same. So what I'll do, I'll take a copy of this code and substitute over here. So program counter doesn't need to move back and forth. So the program counter will execute the sub code over here, okay, the substituted code, this code, and then it will continue with the next line. So with this way, we have the function, because we don't want to write the same code or the logic again and again, and we have also find a way, we have reached to a point where we have a solution, that if we can substitute this code over here, then program counter doesn't need to go back and forth again and again to just execute one or two lines. So for a small code, I think this is not the good way. So to substitute this code over here, there is a functionality in C++ provided. If we write inline function over here, let me take the same example. So what I did is simply I have written inline before the data type. So this function would return A plus B integer it would return. So before the data type, I can simply write inline function, inline, just the inline. So what will happen, the compiler would come to add, and it would know that this function is an inline function. So it means the compiler is responsible for substituting this code over here. Okay. But what is the problem if I can simply write A plus B sum equal to A plus B? Because I don't want to write the addition logic again and again. That's why I'm using this function. It just, I want my PC or the CPU, the less switching overhead. So my PC would always be here, just it would execute the sub code, and then it will come to this next line to execute this code. So I hope you guys are clear what is the need of using an inline function. Okay, so guys, I have written some important points regarding inline function. So let's look at those important points. So the very first point, it is very important that you must know that compiler is responsible for substituting the function code at the place of function call. It means at this point of time, add A comma B. At this point of time, the compiler is responsible for substituting this code over here. Okay, so the less switch overhead would be there. The second point is to minimize the switching overhead. The third is to make function execution more efficient. So the function execution speed would also improve if we use inline function for small logics. Good for a small size or logic functions, right? So guys, this is about the inline functions. So let's discuss another topic. The second topic of today's lecture is recursive functions. Okay, so recursive functions. So before writing a code, so I will also discuss a code in which code we will discuss about the recursive function. Okay, but before that, let me take a simple example so that we can understand why do we need a recursive function first of all. Okay, so let's say we have a large problem P1, and we can divide this problem in small groups of small problem P10. Okay, so we have 10 small problems of a large problem P1. Okay, so we have divided P1 into 10 different sub problems. What if all those sub problems can be solved by using the same logic? Okay, watch my words. What if we can solve all these small problems by using the same logic? Then it means all the functions are calling the same logic. Okay, so whatever we have written inside a function, what if a sub problem can also call the same logic? Okay, so here we have the definition of the recursive function. If a function calls itself, then that respective function is called a recursive function. Okay, we can discuss about this in detail as well. So for that, let me take a simple code. Okay, so that we can understand what is the motive of inventing recursive function. It must have some kind of a need at that point of time. That's why people have invented recursive functions. So this is the very basic example of calculating the factorial of a number. Okay, so how it works, let me give you an overview of that. If we have 3, okay, we want to calculate the factorial of a 3, then it would be 3 cross 2 cross 1. In our basic logic, it would be 6. What if we can write a program for that? So in that case, if you look at it, it is decreasing by 1, okay, and it gets multiplied by it. Okay, so this logic is the same. It is decreasing by 1, and then we are multiplying it with that factor. So for 3f2. So if I want to write the tree for that, how it would be functioning in, using this function is, let's say if we are passing 3, okay, it's the very first of all, we are passing 3 over here, f3. So enter the number, we have entered 3, let's say, and we are passing f3. Okay, so 3 is being passed in this function. 3 is less than equal to 1? No. Okay, 3 is not less than equal to 1. You must pay attention to that, that then it will go to else. So here it will become 3 cross f2. So f2 will also call the same function again, right? And this is the base condition. After that, it will return 1. It will now not go recursively, but at this point of time, when the value is equal to 1 or less than equal to 1, then the function call would stop. Okay, so let me write a tree so that it'd be super easy for you to understand what I'm trying to say. So the factorial of a number 3 cross 2 1, so this one we should reach. This is the base condition. Otherwise the function would go recursively on and on for infinite loop. Okay, so for example we have f3, so it would become 3 cross f2, right? That this f2 would also call the same functionality. Okay, then f2 would become, by using this logic, 2 cross f1, but in case of f1 it will not go to else, it will go to if, because 1 is less than equal to 1, it is true. So f1 would return 1, so this, the calculation of this would become 2, and 2 will be returned as a f2. So if you look at it, it becomes 3 cross 2 cross 1. Okay, so this is how it's being calculated. But in recursive function, we don't need to write this logic for each subproblem, like we have just discussed over here. What if we can solve all these problems by writing the same logic, and we can call the same logic again and again until the problem reaches to the base logic, base function. So this is the base logic, right? This one thing where the program gets stopped. Okay, so this is the way how a recursive function works. So you know that so guys, this is the way how recursive functions work in a program. Okay, and I hope that now you are able to understand why we need recursive function, because the subproblems, okay, this is the subproblems can be solved by using the same logic. Then we don't need to write the code for that sub logic again and again. We can call the same function. So if you paid little attention to that fn minus 1 would also come to this point. The PC would come to this point and execute the same code again and again for that particular value. So a separate tree will be formed. Okay, so guys, this is about the recursive functions. I have written some important points regarding recursive functions, I think 2 or 3. So if a function calls itself, then that function is called recursive function. Okay, second and the very most, and I would say this is the only thing you need to know about recursive, the purpose of using recursive function: to divide the problem in smaller problems till the base condition is reached. So it divides, it keeps on dividing your problem into small problems until and unless the base condition has reached. So we have taken this example earlier as well. We have divided the large problem into 10 sub problems, and I am supposing at SP10 base condition has reached. Okay, like we have used this one, it means it will return in this case 1, it will not keep on going on. Okay, so guys, this is about the recursive function. This is all for today's lecture, and at this point of time we have done with our unit first, and maybe today or tomorrow I will give you an assignment with the deadline. So guys, prepare well for the unit first, and best of luck. Thank you so much guys for today.